A big improvement in macOS Mojave is the way that apps can access data on your Mac. The privacy settings, they're now very similar to how iOS has always done things. So you can find privacy settings by going to System Preferences and then go to Security and Privacy and then Privacy. And then if you want access to actually make changes, you want to authenticate here. Now when you install apps or use apps for the first time, they will often ask you for access to something. So for instance, an app like Skype may want access to your contacts so you can actually make phone calls based on names in your contacts. It may ask you for that when you first run Skype or when you install it. And then you don't have to worry about it. You never need to go here. Matter of fact, the typical Mac user never needs to go into the privacy settings and look at anything. But all the stuff is here so you have full transparency and control. Now it can be a little confusing because it's not really clear why each one of these things exists and what it actually does. Sometimes it makes sense though. Like here under location services, weather has access to that. Of course, because you want the weather to be able to tell you, you know, what your weather is right here. You don't want to have to type in your location each time. So you've got a lot of that. Voice memos, we know, creates a default name based on your location. So that's why it's using location services. But other things aren't always as clear. You know, why does the automator need access to photos? Well, it turns out I know that because I created an automator action that accessed photos and it asked me for permission. But some of this other stuff may not be as clear, like why does some of this need access to accessibility? That kind of thing. So when you're going through here, always keep in mind that a lot of this is kind of difficult to define why the permissions are there. There's no clear reading. But previously, in earlier versions of macOS, it just had permissions and you didn't even know about it. So this is definitely a big improvement. If you look at some of these, you'll see that some of them are turned off, and that might be because you haven't used the app since upgrading to Mojave, or you simply haven't run into that part of the app that uses that information. So for instance, Microsoft Word wants accessibility access. You know, I haven't run into needing that yet and it hasn't asked me for permission. That's why it's not checked. But I can check it here if I wanted to give it that ability in advance. I think the most useful thing here to know is that if you run into a problem with an app and something isn't working right and then you look up a solution, you may find somebody says, hey, try turning on this permission for that app in privacy settings. And this is where to find that. So now you know where to go. You also find some things here at the bottom like information on, you know, advertising, mostly related to Apple's apps like the Mac App Store. And also for analytics, you know, when you install macOS it says, is it okay to share information with app developers or with Apple, you know, when apps crash and things like that. And this is where you can actually toggle those on or off if you felt the need. But for the most part, you know, you would just look through these to see which apps have been granted permission. A good rule though is if you don't trust an app enough to give it permission to access something, like if it wants access to contacts and you don't trust it to give it access to contacts, then you probably shouldn't trust it to be on your Mac at all. So keep that in mind. Other than that, if you really wanted to know why an app needs access to something, then your best bet is to try to contact the developer or look through their support documents and hopefully they mention that in there.